Entrepreneurship and art definitely go together. Just ask Shaiba Muhammad. She is the Arts and Education Council Startup Competition winner. What is it that you think put you over the top?
So I really believe that doing my research and first of all also being an artist myself was my inspiration for coming up with the Makers Program. So really the aim of the program is to create pathways for artists and makers of color to market and sell their products.
And what do you think a support program like this actually does in terms of helping you overcome certain obstacles? And what are some of the challenges that makers of color face when they want to actually be a real businessman or woman?
Right. So makers of color really, so one of the challenges are having access to resources. So St. Louis is actually really great about, we have a lot going on as far as support for startups, incubators, and a lot of things, but makers of color don't necessarily have access to a lot of these programs. So really kind of bridging the gap between introducing these makers and helping them kind of develop the skill sets they need to participate in our startup space.
Okay, well, we already are in love with your skills in terms of making these beautiful pieces, so nice and simple yet impactful. Tell us about some of them.
Yeah, so everything is handmade by myself in my studio. So everything's actually solid brass, crafted by hand. Earrings have sterling silver backings.
Tell me about those sterling silver backings, because some people who don't have allergies do not understand how critical that is.
Oh, so the sterling silver is actually really important. So a lot of people do have sensitivity sometimes when it comes to a base metal such as brass. Yeah. So I do incorporate either gold upon request or sterling silver as standard for to kind of accommodate those people.
Tell me a little bit about your aesthetic, because again, I see some geometry, but I do see a lot of curves, but whatever it is, it's super simple.
Thank you. So I definitely go for simple. So I try to do pieces that are a little bit more architectural, that are really kind of contemporary, simple, easy to wear.
They're almost like statement pieces without having to speak too loud.
Yeah, exactly. So I definitely want them to be noticeable when you wear them, but also not like take over the outfit.
So tell me a little bit about the Arts and Education Council and interfacing with them. What was that like for you?
So it was great. The Arts and Education Council actually selected the Makers Program as one of two winners for their startup competition, which was a partnership between A&E and the PNC Foundation. And they're actually, they awarded us with $10,000 prize award, year of incubation space, networking, professional development, and it's all taking place at their art incubator, the Centene Center for the Arts, and it's Centene Center for the Arts.
And do you guys have a web presence, the Makers?
Yes, so it's actually themakersprogram.com.
Okay.
And we're actually accepting applications for the first cohort right now.
Okay, all right, and deadline for that?
So it's a rolling deadline.
So you guys have no excuses. Get on top of it. In order to learn a little bit more about the Centene Center for the Arts, you could go ahead and just have a little bit of a happy hour. They're having a good time called a Midsummer Night's Drink. That will be at the Centene Center for the Arts, July 20th from 6 until 9, 3547 Olive Street in Grand Center. For more information, just go to keeparthappening.org/YFA. You never know if your favorite jewelry piece might actually help out the St. Louis economy here on the 9 a.m. show.
Reaching out to find you.
Happy. How you doing?
We have your home theater shopping list all written and ready to go on this DVD Tuesday.